Good evening, and I welcome you students. But we are discussing the topic of tissues. Let us relax and relieve the stress and improve our energy levels before we begin the session. All right, sit comfortably on the chair, students, and start. We will inhale and exhale 10 times. Bhastrika. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, come back. Shoulder, remove the stress from the shoulders. Remove the stress from the shoulders. Shoulder rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, come back. Now you have your neck, release your neck, right, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, 2, 4, 5, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Okay, rotate the neck 3 times clockwise, 3 times anti-clockwise, half inhale, half exhale. Slow and gentle. Release the stress from the neck. Relax the muscles of the neck. Reverse. Come back. Release your hands, release your hand, remove, get rid of the stress, get rid of the stress from your hands, shake your hands, shake your hands. All right, shake, tap your feet so that now we are improving our energy levels, blood circulation is complete in the entire body. That's what we wanted. Now, what will we do? We will do some breathing in order to relax our mind, release the negative energy, distractions from the mind by using breathing techniques. What we are going to do? We are going to focus on our breath and we will inhale with count of 5, hold count of 5 and release with 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 from the 2 nostrils. So sit comfortably, spinal cord should be erect. You can put a pillow on the back of the chair. Your 2 laps, your 2 hands relax on your lap or on the table and start. Inhale as deeply as possible. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in your mind. Hold for the same count and then release with the same count. Hold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, release 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Second round, inhale slowly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pay and focus on your breath. Pay attention to your breath. Inhale. Hold, exhale, count 5, inhale, hold 5, count, exhale 5. Last time, inhale, exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, come back, normal breathing, inhale, exhale. breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Pay attention to your breath, observe your breath, fold your two hands, prayer to the God, prayer to the universe. We thank you, God, we thank you, universe, we thank you, environment, for the gift of life, and we promise our best efforts to make a best version of ourselves. Rub your two hands. Heat energy is being produced. Healing energy is being produced like a magnetic field, like a field. Put it on your face. Let this field of the magnet pass to the entire body. Keep inhaling, exhaling. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Gentle massage, eyebrows, face, chin, ears, neck, head. Release all the stress, all the thoughts from your mind completely, and you may open your eyes with smiles. And 1, 2, 3, come back. All right, we have improved our energy levels. We have improved our energy levels. Give me a second. Okay. All right. Now we are set. We have energy. We are relaxed.
Yes, sir.
Our blood circulation is very good. We are ready to start our session. Get ready, students. Okay, students, last time, students, what we have done with you, we are talking about connective tissues.
And we have told you last time in our lecture, we have told you blood is a connective tissue. Why blood is a connective tissue? Blood has a plasma.
Yes,
has
sir.
A plasma?
Yes, sir.
The plasma has got what inside it? There are RBC, red blood capsules, and white blood corpuscles are present. And the plasma contains proteins, plasma contains salts, plasma contains hormones, and blood is flowing through your entire body. And what it is doing, it is transporting gases, digested food, hormones, and waste material to different parts of our body. Therefore, the blood is a connective tissue. This was done in our last lecture. What did we do about blood? And we told you the composition of blood also, and what are the functions of the blood, and RBC, WBC, platelets, and plasma, and what type of composition is there for the bloods. And we also told you something about the groupings of the blood. All right, this was done last time. Now we are coming to another important connective tissue. Bone. Do you have a bone? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Bone is also a connective tissue. You are a skeleton of bones inside you. Now, what is this? Bone is also a connective tissue. It forms the framework that supports your body. Your body, you have a body where it is supported. What is supporting your body? You know from inside, if you have seen the picture of skeleton, there is a skeleton. What is that? There is a framework that supports the body. The framework of bones is there. So, what is important, student? Bone is a connective tissue. It forms the framework. It forms the framework that supports the body. That supports the body. It also anchors the muscles and supports the main organs of the body. it also anchors the muscles and sports main organs of body and sports main organs of body. It forms framework that supports body. It also anchors the muscle and supports main organs of the body. It is a strong and non-flexible tissue. What would be the advantage of these properties for bone? What will be the advantage? Bone cells are embedded in hard matrix that is composed of calcium and phosphorus compound. What is the bone made up of? What is it contains? Which two important elements are there inside the bone? Calcium and
phosphorus.
You know that this, you say eat calcium. Where, in which food you have calcium? Bones. You say to make your bones strong, you should have eat more calcium. You should take more phosphorus. Calcium is present in which food, students?
Milk.
You are taking milk, calcium. So phosphorus, they are the main components composed of calcium and phosphorus compounds. There are compounds of calcium and phosphorus which make up the bone. Bone is a very strong, non-flexible tissue. Your bone is very strong. You know that it is very hard. Non-flexible tissue, porous, highly vascular. Its matrix is made up of proteins, heavily coated with phosphorus, calcium, and magnesium salts. These minerals are responsible for the hardness of the bone. You see, hardness of the bone, what type of minerals are there? Phosphorus, calcium, and magnesium salts. Important point. So the bone, what type of you have? P for phosphorus, C for calcium, and Mg salts. So these minerals are responsible for hardness of the bone. They are responsible for hardness of the bone. Hardness of the bone. Phosphorus, calcium, and magnesium salts. These are the minerals. They are responsible for hardness of the bone. They are responsible for hardness of the bone. Hardness of the bone. Theek hai? Note down every point because they are important. But we are studying connective tissues. Now they will ask a question. What are the functions of the bones? What is the function of the bones, student? It forms endoskeleton of human being and other vertebrates. You see, there is a skeleton on which the body is there. What is that skeleton? That is made up of bones in every vertebrates also. Then it also provides shape and support to the body, number two. So you have a skeleton and the result will be, it will give shape and support to the body. Shape and support to the body. Otherwise, why your body has a shape? Or different vertebrates have different shapes. It protects vital body organs. It will protect vital body organs. Whatever organs are there, they are protected by this. And serve as a storage site of calcium and phosphate. Calcium and phosphate. Very important. Calcium and phosphate. So note down all these. They will ask what are the functions. Connective tissues, we are talking of tissues, and the whole chapter is based on tissues, a group of cells. They will perform specific functions in our body. Blood is the first connective tissue we have shown you. How it is transporting the gases and food and the waste materials to different parts of the body. Now we say that you have a skeleton of bones. They give shape, support, protect the vital organs and serves as storage site for calcium and phosphate. Then we have ligaments. What are ligaments, students? Are bands of tough elastic tissue around your joints. You have joints. How many joints you have? There are so many joints in your body. So there are ligaments. They are elastic tissues around the joint. They connect bone to bone. One bone to this bone is I am bending. So there are connections around the joints. There are joints. We have joints. What is connecting the joints? Ligaments. They connect bone to bone, give your joint support, and limit their movement. There's a limit to which anything can move. So they are going to connect bone to bone. Connect bone to bone. And limit the movement. You have ligaments around your knees. Your knees, ankles, elbows, shoulders, and other joints. Stretching or tearing them can make your joints unstable. See, there are joints. We are stretching, whether you have shoulders, you have elbows, you have ankles, you have knees. There are joints. If we will do too much stretching or tearing, then your joints will become unstable. Note down everything. Ligaments. I can sip water if you have. Oh, water, heal me. Sip water. I'm not drinking, I'm sipping water. Water provides good energy to us. Water is energy. 75% of the body inside water. Once you note down, I will proceed further, students. So bones, their functions, ligaments, all we are talking of different connective tissues. What we said, ligaments often connect two bones together, particularly in the joints, like strong, firmly attached straps of ropes. They stabilize the joint. They will ask you, what are the functions of ligaments? They hold the ends of two bones together. This ensures bones in the joint don't twist too much or move too far apart and become dislocated. The bones have to be there, student. If they are dislocated, then serious problem will come. So how do we maintain that? Like a rope, there are ligaments which will connect the two bones so that they are not dislocated. They are not dislocated and they will stabilize those bones. Note down important points. So ligaments, bones, ligaments, and another one I'm talking of, number two, ligaments, number three, I'm talking of tendons are soft fibrous tissues that connect muscle to bone. You have muscles. And muscle to bone connection. They are connected by muscle to bone. They are connected by the tendons. Fibrous type of tissues. Fiber. You know what is fiber, thread like. Their main function is to transfer muscle generated force to the bony skeleton. You see, muscle, if a force is generated to the muscle, it is transferred to the bony skeleton, facilitating movement around a joint. And as such, they are relatively passive, inelastic, able to resist high forces. They can resist high forces. So they will ask you, what are the function, main function of this? Tendons. What is the main function? To transfer muscle generated force to the to transfer muscle generated force, ठीक है, टू द बोनी स्केलेटन. Skeleton of bones. You are skeleton of bones, students. So it facilitates the movements around the joint. Facilitating movement around a joint. Note down everything, students. Note down everything. You have to note down everything. Okay, note down everything, student. Another areolar connective tissue. What is that, student? Areolar connective tissues. So many types of connective tissues depending on the functions they perform and their location in the body. Is found between skin and muscles. You have skin and muscles. It is found between skin and muscles. Around blood vessels. Around blood vessels. And nerves, blood vessels and nerves in bone marrow. It fills the space inside the organs, supports the internal organs, and helps in the repair of the tissues. So, what is the function of areolar connective tissue? They will ask you functions of areolar connective tissue. It acts as a binding tissue. First, it acts as a binding tissue. Second, binds the skin and the muscles. It is binding the skin and binds skin and muscles. Third, it binds the blood vessels and nerves with other structure of the body. Bind blood vessels and nerves with other structures of the body. Note down everything. Other structures of the body. Fourth, it helps in healing the wounds. It helps in healing the wounds. note down everything. Functions of areolar connective tissue. It acts as a binding tissue. It binds skin and muscles, bind blood vessels and nerves with other structures of the body, helps in healing the wounds. Helps in healing the wounds. So you will see a diagram of this in your NCERT book also. Binding tissue, skin and muscles, bind blood vessels and nerves with other structures of the body, helps in healing the wounds. This is a reticular fiber, fibroblast, macrophage, collagen fiber, mast cell, plasma cell, fibroblast. So we have this one important. Functions are important. Note down. They will ask you what are the functions of these. You can see their diagrams have been provided in the NCERT book. Note down everything, students. Adipose tissue. Another one is coming, adipose tissue. It consists of cells, adipokytes, which are filled with fat globules, matrix, collagen, and elastic fibers. What are these adipose tissues? It consists of cells, adipocytes, which are filled with fat globules, matrix, collagen, and elastic fibers. They will ask you what are the functions. What are the functions of adipose tissues? What are the functions of adipose tissue? Functions of adipose. First, they are fat storing tissues. The fats are stored in where? Fat storing tissues, which are filled with fat globules. These tissues are found below the skin and internal organs. Where they are found? Below the skin and internal organs. Third, due to storage of fats, it acts as an insulator. What is an insulator? What do you mean by insulator? These are the fat droplets, nucleus, adipocyte. It consists of cell adipocytes, which are filled with fat globules, matrix, collagen, and elastic fibers. What do you mean by insulator? What is the meaning of insulator? What the insulator does? When you say it is an insulator, then it will maintain a heat. Insulator doesn't allow the heat gain or heat loss. So the temperature of the body has to be maintained. If it is very cold outside, then what happens? Then body has to still maintain its temperature. And if it is very, very hot, then still body wants to maintain a temperature inside. So it acts as an insulator. Important point. Note down everything. Which are the fat storing tissues? Adipose tissues. And what are the cells? Adipocytes. Note down everything. Next, we are coming to muscular tissues. You have muscles. What are the muscles? What are they are doing? What the muscles are doing inside your body? What the muscles are doing inside your body? How your contraction is taking place? Relaxation is taking place. How it is taking place inside you? You are contracting. You are relaxing. How everything is happening? What is happening?
Muscular tissue.
So, moment of you have seen how the chest is moving, how the body parts move. So, what we have specialized muscle cells, the contraction and relaxation of the cells result in movement. What is happening? Contraction and relaxation. So, we can here we have muscular cells. Muscular tissue consists of elongated cells. They are called muscle fibers. The tissue is responsible for movement in the body. Any movement in the body. Movement in the body. What we are doing, there is a movement in the body. How the body moves? There will be movement in the body. Muscles contain special proteins. Proteins are there. They are called contractile proteins. What do you have? Contractile proteins, which can contract and relax to cause movement. Contract and relax to cause movement. So, contractile proteins. They can contract, contraction, relaxation, contraction. Everything is happening like that inside. Even heart, what is happening in heart? You know heart. Contraction, relaxation. Heart is pumping blood. How it is pumping blood? So, there are muscular tissues which are responsible for movement in the body. And there are proteins which are called contractile protein. They can contract and relax, contract and relax. Contract, relax, contract, relax. What will happen? There are about 600 muscles in the human body. How many? 600. The three main type include skeletal, smooth, cardiac. The brain, nerves and skeletal muscle work together to cause movement. The brain, nerves and skeletal work together to cause movement. This is collectively known as neuromuscular system. What do we call it? Neuromuscular system. Note down each and every term. Neuro is related to the brain nerves, neuro. Muscular system. Neuromuscular system. Note down everything. Three main type of muscles, skeletal, smooth, and cardiac. So they will be responsible for movement in the body by using contractile proteins. So they proteins which can contract and relax. Contract and relax. So all these are compounds, chemicals. Whole body is chemicals. See, and they are doing their work. Therefore, you are saying the three type of muscle tissues are cardiac, smooth, skeletal. Cardiac muscles are located in the walls of heart, appear satiated, and are under involuntary control. Involuntary. They are happening, you know, I'm not doing anything. Heart is functioning by itself. I am not doing anything. We can move some muscles by conscious will. Some muscles we can move by conscious will. Muscles present in our limbs. Limbs move when we want them to and stop when we decide. Such muscles are called voluntary muscles. There are two types of muscles. Voluntary muscles. One, I am taking voluntary vessels, which move by conscious will. You can control them. They will move by conscious will. Conscious will. And there are others. What are we calling? Cardiac and located in the heart are involuntary. Involuntary. So there, the heart is running by itself, student. This is contracting and relaxing, contracting and relaxing. So there is an involuntary control. We have no control over it. It happens naturally, just like cardiac muscles located in the walls of the heart. Cardiac muscles, where they are located? Cardiac muscle cells in the walls of the heart. And muscles present in our limbs. These are the muscles in our limbs. We can consciously control them, but these are not consciously controlled. They are involuntary. Here we are coming to satiated muscle. First one, they are also called as striped or skeletal or voluntary. Voluntary means you consciously, you can use them, control them. The entire muscle shows alternate dark and light strips and therefore called stripped muscle. See, this is a picture which is given in the book, NCRT book. But it shows dark and light strips. There are dark and light strips. You can see light and dark strips, striations, what we call striations. Striation, that is why this is called striated muscle also. They are attached to bones and are responsible for body movement. Where they are attached? They are attached to bones. Striated muscles attached to bones and are responsible for the body movement, function, body movement. Body movement. And are called skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles. Note down everything. You can see the striations, alternate dark and light strips. Alternate dark and light strips. Note down everything. Note down everything. Next, we are coming to smooth muscles or involuntary muscles. They are found in the iris of the eyes, ureters, and in bronchi of the lungs. What is the meaning of involuntary? We have no control. They will happen themselves. Smooth muscles. Cells are long, spindle shaped, and possess single nucleus. Spindle shaped. You can see spindle shaped. Single nucleus. They have single nucleus. Single nucleus. Spindle shaped. The movement of food in alimentary canal. the movement of food in alimentary canal or the contraction and relaxation of blood vessels are involuntary movements. Movement of food in alimentary canal contraction and relaxation of blood vessels contraction and relaxation of blood vessels they are examples of involuntary movements. We cannot really start them or stop them simply by wanting to do. Smooth muscles are shown in this figure, so we have no control over them. Involuntary we cannot start or stop them. That is what we mean by involuntary muscles. Involuntary muscles. Note down. They are smooth muscles. Spinal shaped muscle cell. The picture can be obtained from your NCERT book. Now we're coming to the cardiac muscles. They are involuntary because they are not controlled by our will. Where are they present? Cardiac muscles are present where? They are found in heart. You have heard about cardiac arrest ho gaya. Cardiac arrest ho gaya. Muscles not contracting and relaxing. Cardiac arrest ho gaya. Cardiac chal hi nahi raha. They are what type of muscles? Involuntary. Can you control them?
No, sir.
No. So they are happening by themselves. Neither you start nor you close. They are working. And they are the only muscles which work throughout the life without getting tired or fatigue. Very important. Cardiac muscles. They work throughout life. This is something unbelievable. They work. Is there anything which does not get tired or exhausted? Everything will get tired. But the only muscles which work throughout the life, question will be asked, throughout the life without getting tired or fatigue. Which one is that? Which are those muscles?
Cardiac muscles.
Cardiac muscles. You are sleeping, heart is still working. Does your heart stops working when you sleep in the night?
No, sir.
Other things are not working, but your heart is stopped, still working. So these cardiac muscles are never at rest. They are never tired, never fatigued. They are working. I have no control. So they say, what is the function? They work to keep your heart pumping through involuntary movements. These are the muscle students. See, there's a picture of these cardiac muscles. You can see the striations. You see the dark and light color striations. Nuclei. Important that these cardiac muscle tissue works to keep heart pumping through involuntary movements. They keep your heart pumping. They keep your heart pumping through involuntary movements. Through involuntary movements. This one feature differentiates it from skeletal muscle tissue. Gail asks, what is the difference between skeletal muscle tissue and cardiac muscle? We told you about skeletal. What is the difference? There is important question. What will be the difference between skeletal and cardiac muscle? What is the main difference? This is voluntary. And this is involuntary. It will work by itself. It is not going to stop. But this can be controlled. So it does through specialized cells called pacemaker cells. These control contractions of your heart. What are those cells? Special cells. So the cells are those which will make a difference. For different functions, you have different cells. What are those specialized cells called? Pacemaker cells. These control contractions of the heart. Which cells? Pacemaker cells. They will control the contractions of your heart. Heart is relaxing, contracting, relaxing, contracting. Note down everything, student. So they will ask you compare the structures of different types of muscular tissues. Note their shape, number of nuclei, position of the nuclei within the cell. So you can do this work yourself, complete it. We have already discussed all types of the muscular tissues. The three types we have discussed, and also their shape have been given. Number of nuclei, position, everything. Now the next one we are coming is nervous tissue. What is nervous tissue? It is found in the brain, spinal cord and nerves. It is responsible for coordinating and controlling many body activities. The cells in nervous tissue that generate and conduct impulses are called neurons or nerve cells. These cells have three principal parts. What I'm talking, nerve cells. Neurons or nerve cells. They will ask a question on that, students. How many? They have three principal parts, the dendrites, the cell body, and one axon. The cells of nervous tissue are highly specialized, and the cells of the tissue are called neurons. Nervous tissue stimulates and transmits stimulus very rapidly from one place to another part of the body. A neuron consists of cell body which comprises of nucleus and cytoplasm from which long thin hair-like parts arise. Important, note down. They will ask this question. Neurons, what are neurons? Are cells considered to be bases of nervous tissue. They are responsible for electrical signals that communicate information about sensations. Sensations. Something is hot. How do you know? You touch something very hot, something cold. Sensation. Where is the sensation? Neurons. They are considered to be the basis of nervous tissue. They are responsible for electrical signals that communicate information about senses and that produce movement in response to those stimuli along with inducing thought processes within the brain. So your brain knows, oh, this is hot, this is cold. Some danger is there. The brain knows how all this is happening. Neuron, unit of nervous tissue. Neuron consists of a cell body with a nucleus. Where is the nucleus? This is a nucleus. and cytoplasm nucleus and cytoplasm, from which long thin hair like parts arise. Figure this one. Thin long hair like part arise. Usually each neuron has a single long part called axon and many short branched parts called dendrites. See, this is a nucleus. This each has a single long part called axon and many short parts, dendrites. Called dendrites. An individual nerve cell may be up to a meter long. 1 meter long. 1 meter is quite a big size. 1 meter long nerve cell. Many nerve fibers bound together by connective tissue make up a nerve, and that is how they become nerve. This is axon, nerve ending, dendrite, nucleus. This is a cell body. Cell body, nerve ending. Nerve ending. Nerve impulses allow us to move our muscles when we want to. The functional combination of nerve and muscle tissue is fundamental to most animals. This combination enables animal to move rapidly in response to stimuli. And any stimuli is there, they move rapidly in response to the stimuli. So all this information, very important. Note down, student, the various muscles which are present. And that was the last one which we have told you, the nervous tissue. And therefore, this ends up the topic of the tissues. What is the next topic going on?
Sir, they haven't told, but they would start with atoms and molecules.
Okay, we will do that. No problem. So we will continue. There will be question answer sessions and quiz on this tissue. We have time for that. We will continue and see you in the next class. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.